This is just a very quick Sunday morning video just to give you a clearer illustration of the sorts of scripts and other sort of tracking cookies which might exist in websites and potentially how we can solve user privacy issues and such like using stacks such as Cookie Manager, Gateway, Topbox, Floating Content and things like that. What I've done here is just to go ahead and create a very simple Wrapper Weaver project file, and I've embedded a YouTube video in my page. Straight away, if I was to open Web Inspector, click on the Storage tab, we can see that before we've even begun to play the video, YouTube is collecting quite a lot of information from us and setting tracking cookies. There's new privacy laws coming in at the end of May, which greatly restrict what data we can collect from users or what third-party services can collect from users. And typically that's going to be accomplished by getting consent from the user to opt in before they're able to view certain content on your website or access particular services such as embedded video. Logistically, this is going to prove quite difficult in Wrapper Weaver in certain setups, but I'm hoping that the new Cookie Manager stack might help alleviate some of the problems. So what we can do is we can continue to put our, you know, our YouTube code in the page like this, but then we can actually use the Cookie Manager stack and conditionally display this content depending on whether somebody has opted in or opted out, and sort of, in other words, given their consent to viewing this content. And to do that, we use a Cookie Manager stack, and we set the configuration mode to a get cookie. And in this case, we're going to look for a cookie called allow cookies with a value of true. So only if the cookie exists on the user's computer would we display this YouTube content to them. Otherwise, they wouldn't see anything on the page. And just to prove that, if I go back now and just preview the page, you can see nothing loads because we haven't got consent from the user to display this content. How do we actually get consent from the user? Well, again, we can use the Cookie Manager stack. I can drag and drop a copy into the page, and in this instance I can set it to create a cookie, and I'll just change the label to create cookie. I can also add a second stack to delete the cookie. I'll preview the page. So we've got two buttons here, create cookie and delete cookie. If I create the cookie, we've now opted in and given consent to load the YouTube code in our website, in our web page here. But equally so, I can delete the cookie and it deletes the cookie as the name suggests, and that content is no longer shown within the page. And this is applicable to many, many different types of stack you might be using. You can put in certainly things like Google Analytics code into the true field here of Cookie Manager. You might have other stacks or scripts or services which depend on third parties. Things like maps, embedded audio, embedded video, anything like that, which might have links to third party websites, and where there might be a potential risk of user data or information being siphoned from your website off onto a third party site. And what we're doing here is we're putting the user in complete control of opting in or opting out, depending on their personal preferences. And straight away, what you can see here is that this works really well, but it might be a bit cryptic to the average user to your website. You know, they might be thinking, well, hang on a minute, what's a cookie? You know, why does this affect me? Why do I need to click this button? Why is there stuff missing from the page? So we need to sort of repackage the setup in a much more user-friendly manner. And something like the Gateway stack, which I provide with the Stacks for Stacks website, is absolutely perfect for this task. And we can combine something like Gateway with our Cookie Manager stack. In this case, what I've done is I've left the Cookie Manager stack in the page here, still got the HTML code for our YouTube video, but I've gone ahead and added a gateway stack. I've just put in some very simple information for the user to read about, and I've set up a continue button. The important thing to consider here is that in Gateway, I've set up the option for cookie tracking. and I've actually given the gateway stack the same cookie name and value as what I was using on the previous example for setting and deleting the cookie for Cookie Manager. And I've just gone ahead and created a custom close button at the bottom here in the gateway settings, which will allow the user to dismiss the gateway stack and opt into accepting cookies from potentially, you know, third party services and such like. So if I now go and preview a page, as the page loads, our YouTube video isn't shown, but we do have at the bottom here the gateway stack, and it's displaying information to the user about clicking through to read the privacy policy. But if the average user is okay with accepting cookies, which majority are, they can simply click on the continue button here. The page will refresh, up comes our YouTube video, and the message about the cookie tracking and the privacy policy is now gone. But obviously a user could still, if they wanted to change their mind at a later date, go to your privacy policy page and opt out of these cookies again. This is something which is going to affect all users worldwide. It's not just for EU website owners and users. You know, if you're building a website which is going to potentially be viewed by people in the EU, you need to be adopting these best practices right now before the law takes effect. There are a couple of stacks available on the market already, I've noticed, which can do pop-ups and display messages about cookies. The issue I've got is from the ones I've experimented with, they display a message on the page, but they still allow these potentially invasive scripts and other cookies to be set in the background. So I kind of take the opinion that they are more of a cosmetic embellishment to websites rather than a solution like this, which is actually going to regulate what content a user is served up based on whether they've opted in or opted out of receiving cookies and such like. So therefore I would say that this is probably a better solution to go with in the long term if you want to comply with the new privacy laws coming into effect. If you do have any questions, then feel free to get in contact with me by email, and I'm already in charge of updating privacy policies and opt-in and opt-out for several client websites at the moment. We're quite busy at the moment with that. That's one of the reasons why we developed this new Cookie Manager stack, is because there's nothing else available really which was suitable. This solution we've tested quite a lot already, and we found works very well. So it's free to download. Have a look at the website. It'd be at stacksforstacks.com/cookie-manager. There's a working example on there of the stack, and you can read about what it does, how to set it up. That's all for now, and goodbye for today.